Good morning, children. So, student, let's start another topic from your chapter number 6, and that will be training methods. Student, in the previous video, we have learned about education, training, and development. There, we have discussed about why we call training as a narrow concept and why we call development as a wider concept. We have also learned about what are the different advantages a trained employee give to the organization or a trained employee give to himself. Now children, today we will be discussing about the training methods. The training methods basically by which we can provide training to the employee. Now training methods are divided into two parts. The first one is your on-the-job training method and second one is your off-the-job training methods. Now, children, as the name is saying on-the-job training method, it means this is the type of method where we are providing training to the employee while he or she is working inside the organization. It means we can have an example of learning by doing here. The employee is working in the organization. They are somebody, the supervisor, who will be guiding him, instructing him, or providing him training. So, because all these training are provided while the employee is working in the organization, we call this on-the-job training methods because we are providing him training while he is working on the job. The next type of training method is off-the-job training methods. Now, off-the-job training method, student, is just opposite of your on-the-job training methods because here we used to have two things. Either first we provide training to the individual and after that we appoint the person inside the organization, or the second thing is that we take the employee out from the organization in some another area where we provide him training. So the employee is not on the job while he is trained. That is the reason we call this off the job training methods. Now, like we can have example of lecture based training. These all are the example of off the job methods because that time when we give the lecture for providing training to the employee, that time he is not working. That is the reason we call off the job training method. So next we will have training methods on the job. Now when we talk about on the job methods where we are providing training to the employee while he is working inside the organization, again on the job can be divided into 6 parts. You can see the images also: orientation training, job instruction training, apprenticeship training, internship and training, job rotation and coaching. These all 6 type of training are provided to the employee or individual while they used to work inside the organization and while they are working on their job. Now, according to our syllabus, we will only cover the 4 training method of on-the-job training method, and that will be your apprenticeship training, coaching, internship training, and your job rotation. So let's start with the first one, that is your apprenticeship training. Now, what it basically means. So student, these all 4 what we are going to read here is related with providing training to the employee while they are actually working. Keep this in your mind. So the first sub part of on the job training method is apprenticeship programs. This basically said that put the trainee under the guidance of master worker. It means there will be one person who will be master worker in that particular field, and we will be putting employee whom we want to give training under his guidance. Now these are designed to acquire a high level of skill. It means we used to provide this type of training when the job seeker or the people who are seeking to train want to get a higher skill job, like plumbers, like electricians, like iron workers. So you all know they have to be trained before they actually work, right? So these are trainees
who spend a prescribed amount of time working with an experienced guide or trainer. There is a person who is experienced in that particular work, and this person used to guide the other trainee. They provide a particular specified time to all these trainees, whether they are fast learner or slow learner, and according to their time, they used to guide them, they used to provide them directions, and they used to evaluate it also, that how much learn has been or how much skills has been gained from all these trainees. And if there is any employee who need more extra time, the extra time can be provided. So the first on the job method, that is apprenticeship training method, it basically say that this is used for all those seekers, those who want to be a higher level of skills, like plumbers, electrician or iron workers. We used to appoint one person there, trainer, who is expert in that particular field and who used to give guidance and who used to train the employee while they are actually working inside the organization. Now, our next method is coaching method. Now, coaching method of on-the-job training said that in this method, the superior guide and instruct the trainees as a coach. It means they are two person there, the superior who is guiding and instructing the trainee. Trainee means the person who want to learn the skills as a coach. The coach or counselor set mutually agreed upon goals, suggest how to achieve these goals, periodically review the trainee's progress and suggest changes required in behavior and performance. It means the coach or the trainer or the superior, they used to make a agreed goal, mutually agreed goal. Mutually agreed goal basically means mutually concerned between the trainers and the trainee. They make a goal, and then time to time it become the duty of the coach or the supervisor to see whether the goal has been achieved or not. They used to, the superior guide the trainee, the superior used to check the progress of the trainee and suggest him the changes if it is required in his behavior and performance. The trainee work directly with the senior manager, and the manager take full responsibility for the trainee coaching. It means here the senior person, they used to take the training of their junior person. They took the full responsibility them for them by guiding them also time to time, by reviewing them also, and to see whether the development has been done or not. Now, this is basically why we are going through with the option of coaching here, why the manager or the supervisor is guiding or giving training to the employee who is working under him, so that they in future the trainee can learn his work and he can be get a chance of promoting to that particular position also. So that is basically a second method of on the job training, that is coaching method. You have to remember here that the supervisor or the coach make a mutually objective after talking to the trainee that what should be achieved, what should they learn, and time to time see that whether they are able to learn or not. And in case the coach feel that there should be certain changes in the behavior or the skill or the performance of the trainee, he or she used to inform and change according to the need. Now, the third way of on-the-job training method is internship training method. Now, children, internship training method, you have listened also this. This is basically a joint program. The joint program of training which educational institutions and business firm cooperate. It means this is basically a joint program of training which is basically conducted between the educational institutions, those who are providing educational qualification, and the business firm where these educational qualification is required. They selected candidate and carry on their regular study for the prescribed period. They also work in some factory or office to acquire practical knowledge and skill. It means Once, what the educational institutions did,
once the educational qualification has been done, they used to make a contract between the organization and they used to impart the students into that particular organization so that they can get a practical knowledge also. That is called internship. Now next is your job rotations. Now as the name is saying, job rotation means where we will be rotating the employee from one job to another job so that they can able to learn the skill of all the jobs. Now this kind of training involves shifting the trainee from one department to another or from one job to another. Now what will happen when we will shift the employee from one job to another, when we will shift the employee from one department to another? So in this case, the trainee will be able to gain a broader understanding. He will be able to gain the understanding of all the part of the business, how the organization as a whole is functioning. So by which in future, the organization can find him easy to promote him also and to replace him or to transfer him in any way wherever it is required in the organization. Now these all are the on-the-job training methods which we are providing to the employee while they are working inside the organization. Now next type of training method is off-the-job training method. Student, off-the-job training method basically said that we are providing training to the employee by taking him outside from the organization, or it's an individual whom we are training first and after that, that person will be appointed for a particular job. Now you can see here, these all are the different manner by which we can provide off the job training method. Like see, vestibule training method, case study, role playing, stimulations, laboratory training method, lecture, conference and films. Now we will be covering only the 6 method out of this. Let's start with the classroom or lecture method, or which we call as a conference method also. Now what is lecture method or classroom method or conference method? Now the lecture or conference approach is well adopted to conveying specific information, rules, procedures or methods. The use of audio visual or demonstration can often make a formal classroom presentation more interesting while increasing retention and offering a vehicle for clarifying more difficult point. The lecture method or the classroom lecture method or conference method basically said, student, that these, when you talk about the lecture method, these are just a combined form of conference also, right? So lecture or conference method basically say that this is just an approach by which we can able to provide training to the employee by giving him a lecture and using a method of audio and visual mode, right? Here we are able to convey the information, we are able to convey the rule, procedures of working inside the organizations and methods of working in the organization by the help of lecture or by the help of audio or visual round. So this is called the lecture room method or the classroom method or conference method. Now next is films. Now this is the another off the job training method, where basically what we do, we can provide informations and demonstrate skills that are not easily represented by other techniques. We use for this a film method. Means we provide whatever we want to teach to our individuals, we used to show that all teaching skills by the help of films way. Now means visual way they. Now next is case study method. Now student, case study you should be knowing, because in class 12 we are having every chapters case study based questions also. Where what happened in that, we basically took an actual experience of the organization as a form of case. We represent that, we describe that, and accurately as possible as we try to find out the real problem by managing and facing it. So according to the case study method, trainees study the cases. We used to provide them a particular cases. They study that cases. They determine the problem of that case. they analysis the case, they try to find out the causes of that problem, develop the different alternative for solving that problem, they take out a final solution, select that and believe that this is the best solution and implement it. That is case study methods, right? Next is your computer modeling method. Now, computer modeling method is basically a stimulating work. Like, it stimulates the work environment by programming a computer to imitate some of the realities of job and allow learning to take place without the risk or higher cost that would be incurred if a mistake were made in real life situation. It means, according to the computer modeling method, instead of creating a real situation, what we basically do, we used to make a programming in the computers. Like, we used to play a lots of game in the computer, the same way we used to set up a programming inside the computer, programming related with that work which we are going to do actually later on. We used to make programming for that in the computer. According to the programming, we used to try to learn things there. We used to do programming there to see that in case there is any risk occurred there, we don't have to go through with a higher cost of losses. Now next is vestibule training. Vestibule training basically said that this is provided to the new employee. New employee basically means employee learn their job on the equipments they will be using, but the training is conducted away from the actual work floor. Actual work environment are created in a classroom and employees use the same material, files and equipment. This is usually done when employees are required to handle a very sophisticated machinery and equipment. It means when we talk about vestibule training, these type of training are provided to all those new employees who have to handle a very costly type of machinery. We try to provide them this type of training so that we can try to remove the losses or risk which can occur if they do not able to handle these machinery properly. So what basically we do in the vestibule training, children? We used to provide learning to the employee, not inside the job. We use all the equipment out from the organization into a different workflow where we try to create the situation, but all the equipments are actually equipments. There is somebody, supervisor, in front of whom we provide them material like files, equipments and other machinery, and we see that how employees are handling these sophisticated machinery. So whenever there is any new appointment, first we go through with the vestibule training if they have to use sophisticated or high costly or risky machines. Now next is your program instructions. Now program instruction is again the another way of providing training. In this method, it incorporates a pre-arranged and proposed equations of some specific skills or general knowledge. Information is broken into meaningful unit and these units are arranged in a proper way to form a logical and sequential learning package from simple to complex. The trainee goes through these units by answering question or filling the blank. Now program instruction basically say that whenever we have to provide any training to the trainee, we try to give him a particular case. In that case, we try to give him lots of question, and these question we frame in such a way that first the simple questions will come. We used to divide that whole case into a small units. Then first the simple units will come, and slowly we will take him from simple to difficult way, right? So in this way, the trainee will go through with a small unit by answering one question to the another question. So children, with this we have finished with our chapter number 6. In the next video, we will be discussing about the case study of chapter number 6, staffing.